On this edition, we'll be taking a further stroll, learning the principles of the kingdom of God. The Bible said, "Wherewith will a young man make his way pure? But by taking heed according to the word of the Lord." May the Lord himself teach us. May he establish our foot. May he preserve us. May the God who said David is a man after his own heart keep us from the slippery places of emotional life. Join me as we step on this ride.
No guy like Jesus. No guy. Who young did that be? That babe is one of the most senior babes that will ever live. The Pharisees questioned Jesus. One answer Jesus sent them sleeping. That babe went question in, question out. That's the only person I've seen that took Jesus on the ride. Your relationship will take you on the ride either to miracles or to disaster. When the men in that city came in John chapter 4, they said to the woman, "We have not only believed because of you, we have believed because we have heard. Please stay with us extra days." But in another city, Jesus casted out demons out of the man. The man came to his senses, just like some people come to their senses in their relationship life. An homosexual needs to come to his senses. Someone who is addicted to porn needs to come to their senses. People involved in bestiality needs to come to the fact they need to come to double senses. Jesus restored a madman. The people came from the city and said to Jesus, "You with all your anointing, get out." That's what our society looks like. When a person says he's signing a contract, a covenant of marriage based on virginity, they look at the person and society. How can you, at 23, not have had sex? Jesus made a man straight in his mind. The city came and said, "Get out." Will you be like them? Or will you be like the first city where Jesus spoke to the lady and the city said, "Please stay well closed"? It was business. In the first city, that lady was already dealing with five men. Like I said, if it were a European country, she would have made so much money from divorce. And I'm sure every other man in the city knew it was just a matter of time she would catch up with us. So when Jesus caught up with her and was able to subdue her, they paid attention to Jesus because their monies were saved. But you see, the other city where the man was mad, it also affected their business. They were hearing this, which according to scriptures they should not have been involved in. 2,000, that's not small. Only the fleet of cars, 2,000 cars, that's not small business. Only the fleet of planes, airplanes, 2,000 airplanes, that's not going to be a small business. When those pigs ran into the river, they knew that if this man stayed a little while with his righteousness, we're going to lose all the prostitute shrine. Or you're not going to resist the covenant because the shrines of the prostitutes are selling. God will collapse all shrines of prostitutes in our city in the name of Jesus. Yeah. You and I will be an example and a model of a covenant relationship. Yeah. Number three, for sake of time. When? We dealt with what? Which? When can I begin this emotional relationship? People have asked me at different forums, how old must I be to get into a relationship? I need to warn you, it's not really about age in numbers, but it's about age in maturity. It's not age in numbers, but age in maturity. We'll deal with maturity on five sides. This is very important, and I'd like you to please note and follow me. Five sides. Number one, among the five, there will be more. Mental maturity. If I take our nation, Nigeria, as an example, our mental faculties are usually developed in school. We go from primary school to our secondary school, then to our tertiary education. Now, you cannot have access to the tertiary education, the polytechnics or the university, if you don't have five white papers, including English and maths, am I right? Right. For someone who is 25, struggling to make his English paper, who cannot yet process his admission, is it matured enough for a relationship? But he's 25 years old. Mentally speaking, it's not qualified. For a fresh graduate whose parents went to the village to collect money to pay the school fees, that is 25. Is he qualified to start looking for a babe? But I thought he was 25 years old. Because he doesn't even have the certificate. that will end in a job talkless of work. Men resign and are retired from their job. But men are never retired or resigned from their work, because their work is their gift. So while in the pursuit of your mental capacity, you need to focus to a high level. You need to pursue it to an extent where you are certain that with this qualification, I can have the minimum of life. So if anyone comes toasting you around who does not have anything to show for his mental capacity, please send him on a repeat course. Mental maturity. 2.
Pastor K will be right back after these messages.
Financial maturity. I like this. How do you get into a relationship and get into marriage without money for house rent? As a bachelor, you can jump from one friend's house to another friend's house and settle the dinner for the day. How do you do that as a husband of one wife, three children, and there is no dinner to serve? How do you jump? This is the proof of financial capacity, the ability to pay tithes. That's your smallest step. You know why? Anyone who cannot give God 10% out of what he earns, why will he take care of you? When economic meltdown, like they say in our nation, comes, from where will you survive? When there is a loss of job, like Peter went to work that day, and then there was meltdown in the sea because nothing happened overnight. He was a professional, he was a skillful guy, he was a brilliant guy, he taught generation fishermen like I thought. But that day there must have been an economic meltdown in the river, and so the fishes did not respond. What will you do? How will you solve your financial problem? But there was a beautiful Jesus. Jesus said to him, "Can I borrow your boat? And to every debit there's a corresponding credit, and there's interest for loan." All the message Jesus preached that day did not enter Peter's brain, because there was nothing to take home to his wife. So he wasn't listening to the message. Jesus returned from his preaching and said, "Peter, move a little, throw your net." Once Jesus said that, he resonated with Peter's heart, because in his heart he was crying, "How do I settle my house?" When he caught an overflow, he knew there was a master fisherman, Kyle Tiller. If Jesus was supposed to be a businessman and he was in the fish industry, which other company would sell when he's alive? If there was a guy to trust your life on, it's a guy who knows Jesus, because he will make money finally. He maketh rich and added no sorrow. There was a guy to stop trusting that guy with Camry, still in Belgium car. Cool down. And they got it with Yahoo Yahoo. The police will soon come and look for that car. And if you are the wife, what God has joined together, car won't separate. When you go to jail together. Find a man who loves God, whose heart is stayed on God. He can't lack Kayalaba. You know why? Marriage and relationship were based on work in the garden. If the man has work that God appointed, who can disappoint the thoughts of God? It declares the end before the beginning. He planted 4 trees in the Garden of Eden. The first tree was called the tree good for sight. The second tree was called the tree that was good for food. The third tree was called the tree of knowledge of evil. Then the fourth tree was, no, I think the third one, what's it called? The first one was tree of sight. Second tree that was good for food. The third tree, the tree of knowledge. No. Please, let's go to Genesis. I just thought that you need to see this. If you see this, I think Genesis chapter 2. Let's take it. Some believers are afraid to get into relationship with other believers because they think they are not financially loaded. Not a genuine believer. Right. First Peter chapter 2 verse 9. Genesis chapter 2 verse 9. "And out of the ground made the Lord God to grow every tree that is pleasant to sight." Tree 1. 2. "And good for food." 2. 3. "The tree of life also in the midst of the garden." Then the fourth one, "The tree of knowledge of good and evil." 4 trees. Money buys food, am I right? But that was only the second tree. The first tree was the tree of sight. Sight is called, and in another language, vision. Assignment is called a vision. And for every assignment God gives, God will back it up. So God brings a provision for the vision. So you are established if you can see more than you can chop. Don't let them use man's ice cream to block your brain. They use touch to block Samson's brain. Because he has one shoe today, it's not a problem. Log up to the satellite of heaven and find out what's his destiny. It may be that he's supposed to own a shoe factory in Italy, producing Italian leathers. So don't measure him with his one shoe. Measure him by the shoe factory. He calls those things that be not. Let's take the third point. Financial maturity. 3, spiritual maturity. Oh, I like that. Spiritual maturity. In Galatians chapter 4, verse 1, he said, for as long as the heir remained a child, it's not different from a servant, and he will suffer what servants suffer. Imagine an occultic man treating you as a woman, and you get back home to tell your husband, and your husband falls down
and says, we are finished. Because another occultic man has just threatened him in the office. Where will be your security? If your husband asks you, what did you say? Did you say someone threatened you? Give me the person's number. And your husband called the line and said, my name is Pastor K. Because in case you threaten Miss Universe, that's how you're going to get my call. My name is Pastor K. My wife just said, confirm. If they stammer at the other side, then I know that he's alive. But if he's bold enough to say, I said, I will book an appointment for him at 12 midnight that day. I will delete his file, and his record will not be found among the living. Jesus saw a tree. He was hungry. There was no relationship that day. Because if he met the woman, the hunger would go. So he saw a tree. He assumed there should be food. But it was not the season. When he got to the tree, Jesus wired it a curse. And the tree died. You will harass my wife, and you will leave. It's not among the living. It must be with Lazarus. Your journey has ended on planet Earth. Look for a man who knows God. Look for a man who carries the presence of God. Who needs one word and an angel can dismantle a whole nation. Let's move on. Don't marry a boy. Marry a man. For as long as the heir remaineth a child, don't marry a boy. Boys don't take responsibility. Men take responsibility. Adam was a boy. How did you know you are naked? The woman. Don't marry a boy. Boys stand spiritually because they hear God. Can I teach you this? We're running out of time. When a man is spiritual and he's supposed to be the head, he has capacity to see into what God is showing. He has capacity to taste into what God is preparing. He has capacity to hear into what God is saying. He has capacity to feel what God is about to do. Because almost the 5 senses rest in the head. And the man is supposed to be the head. But if he's not spiritual, then you can imagine the disaster. Because he's blind and cannot see. Marry a man like Elisha, who a whole band of army arose. And Elisha said to his servant, relax. Simple guys. Elisha had just been telling the king what the other king was planning. The other king found out and said, who is revealing our secret? They said it's nobody but one prophet. The king was stupid enough to say, 50 soldiers, go and arrest him. The man who is giving your secret, they should go and arrest him. He will not know your secret for his own secret. So when they came and the servant said, alas, master, we're finished. Elisha said, you are finished. I'm not finished. He said, sir, you don't understand. There are soldiers outside. He said, Lord, show him the host of heaven. They opened his eyes. Don't marry a man who is blind. Don't marry a boy who is blind because men have open eyes. Praise God. Mental maturity, financial maturity, social maturity. Social. In the book of Mark chapter 4 verse 18 and 19, The seed had fallen on different soils, but I like to take this particular one. The one that fell among the rocky ground. The Bible said it grew, but because there was no much soil, it was choked and it died. And when Jesus was teaching us, he said, because of the riches and the cares of this life, then I asked the question, is anything wrong with the cares of this life? Food, clothes, shelter. Is anything wrong? Would you marry a man that can't give you food? Would you like to stay with a man that cannot give you clothing? Would you like to live with a man that cannot give you shelter? So I said, so Lord, what's behind the cares of this life? It's not primarily the food, clothing, and shelter. It is the degree to which you pursue it that becomes the problem.
Pastor K will be right back after these messages.
The question is, Pastor said, don't marry, don't go with a boy, go with a man. So I don't really understand. The man there, don't go with a boy, go with a man. So I want to throw more light on it.
A man is someone that takes responsibility of whatever happens. But a boy will always shift it to push the blame to someone else. So a man is somebody that is mature, spiritually, physically, in all aspects of life. Praise the Lord. So, but a boy is mommy's boy, both spiritually and physically in every area. Praise the Lord.
All right. The difference between a boy and a man, just like my wife said, it's in one word called responsibility. Responsibility. It's not in age. It's possible to find a man that is 18 years old, and it's possible to meet a boy that is 35 years old.
Wow.
I like to say this to the Nigerian Christians. I think, with all due respect, many of our leaders are boys. No one is standing up for the gospel to speak. Daniel was a man. There's a king in the Bible from Israel, I think Joachim or whatever. The last king that was exported to Babylon. He was fed from the king's meal in the palace, and it was a favor. Yeah, Daniel got into that palace as a slave boy, and Daniel will refuse to eat the eatries of the king. That's a man. That king was a boy. Anyone who dodges responsibility is a boy. Can I say to you, the Nigerian National Anthem, the second stanza says this: O God of creation, direct our noble cause. Guide our leaders right. Help our youth the truth to know. God cannot guide a boy. God only guides a man who has insight. God is looking for youth we can raise to teach the truth so that he can have somebody to guide. An husband that will not take responsibility for the wife and for the children is a boy. Boys end weeping. Ahab was a boy. Jezebel was a man. Yeah. Ahab was a boy. He was always sucking, always crying, always reporting back. Had no mind of his own. A boy is one that has a mind of his own. I gave you an example while I was sharing with you. A boy is the one that gets the lady pregnant and makes statements like this. Eh? Don't you know what your mate does with such things? You want to spoil my career? That's a boy. He may be 30 years old. But a man shouts, wow, when he hears that the wife is pregnant. A man has an answer when there is no answer. A boy collapses. What's Abraham's son's name? Isaac. Isaac said to the father, Father, the fire, the wood, the knife, where is the lamb? A boy will have said, God told me you are the lamb. And he will have collected a holy taekwondo kick. Remember that Abraham was already 90 years old. Or he was even older than... He was older than 90, he was older than 100. He gave birth to Isaac at 100. This was a teenager. So let's assume 13 years old. But fit. 13 years against 100 years in taekwondo kick. What do you think will have happened? That will have been a Tyson blow. And that will have been the end of everything God promised. But the man in Abraham came out and said, God will provide himself a lamb. What makes you a man is the development of your spirit man. God said concerning Jesus, this is my beloved son in whom I am well pleased. How many people can God put such guarantee on? Boys don't ask questions when it comes to principle. They go with their life. They live for something. They don't live by tradition. They live by the word. I hope that will encourage you. God bless you. Hallelujah.
All right. On the last one you just said now, differentiating between a boy and a man. Okay, I want to know also the difference between a girl and a woman, if there is any.
I think my wife, she will set that ball rolling for you.
Hello, praise God.
Hallelujah.
I ask, since there's a difference between a boy and a man, I want to know if there's also a difference between a girl and a woman. So, thank you.
Sure there is, but I need to search my heart. Have you ever heard about this word, daddy's girl? Do you hardly hear daddy's boy? Who do you hear? Mommy's boy. This is a girl. That lady that marries and think is mate with her husband, that's a girl. Because you both have BSc, or you even have a PhD and he has a master's degree, you are still his mate, not his mate. That, I want to use girl now, permit it. I would have loved to use lady. That girl who is married, but with a phone call, the father calls and picks her bag and sweeps off to answer her father without the permission of her husband, is a girl. A woman is under authority and under cover. So, to respond to a call, you must apply to the embassy. You don't go to any country just at your will because you have money. You apply for their visa. They approve it before you go spend your money. A girl is one who thinks is equal to a man. A woman is one who comes down for a man. I know there are other deeper truths, but I need to search my spirit to give it to you. Maybe when we come on the next edition, I'll be prepared with a dossier for you. Praise God.
That you earlier said that we must come to church. Someone will ask, if I must come to church to get my spot or whatsoever, someone will ask, is it by, like, being a lady, is it by speaking in tongues to say, yes, this must be the man I'm looking for? Whether you said yours, my first question you ask, okay, I should repeat my question. Okay, I was asking, like, you said you come to church to look for our spot. If I must come to spot, must I find it by speaking in tongues? This one speaks in tongues. The second one says, by the first question you asked earlier before now, that you were helping, watching the toilet. I wanted to ask, is it a right of doing such, or is it?
Put your hands together for that man. Put your hands together for him. I like every lady to listen to his heart. He's asking out of the fear of a man. I like every lady to listen. What he has asked you is behind the heart of every man that you are seeing. The day you take a man for granted, you will see the lion in him. You will see the king that is in him. The day you learn to pamper him, you see the pet in him. May I start from your second question? It's not entirely a right. It's a privilege. Just the same way, it's not entirely a right for the man to demand for the woman to support the finances and the running of the home. Every man should also know it's a privilege. So you don't wake your wife in June and say, rent is due in July. What are you bringing? If that's acceptable to the men, then let it be acceptable to the women. That support is not a right, but it's something that should be given. Not the one you wake your husband, and he go and fetch water. You're likely never to get that help for a long time. Rather, that's one of the qualities of a girl. The one that feels is my right. Rather, appreciate him for the help he has rendered, and you will get more help without soliciting. So it's not a right. Just like it's not a right for the man to also think the wife should come and support him to run the finances of the home. The first question, can I take that again? All right, I got it. Thank you. You don't necessarily have to find who you will marry in church. There was a question, one of the principles was where to find who to marry. Where did we say? Where the water is. What does the water represent? The word. Right. If I came to visit you in your house and you're a believer, you're a genuine believer, and I'm a believer, and there is probably two or three of your friends that are with you, and they're girls, do you know that if I enter your house, because we are believers and within some few minutes we're going to speak in line in the atmosphere of God, do you know we have started creating the water and stirring it? Do you know in the midst of that atmosphere I can find who to marry among the girls sitting down? The word is readily available in church. There are devils in church as well. But anywhere you find the word of God, genuine, that atmosphere creates for you capacity to see. Jacob saw at the well. Moses saw at the well. Eve was created out of the dust of man. The dust was made out of the ground for which the rivers flowed through. Jesus himself is the river of life. So it's not necessarily the four. In fact, church is not the four walls we come to. Church are the people who carry Christ. Am I right? So when you come in contact with the church, the real person who bears the image of God and who lives the life of God, then your perceptions are open to find out who is yours. Thank you.
Hope that few minutes have made your moment. I've had a wonderful time. I hope the principles that you have learned can order your steps in life. Hope they can be light to your path. Hope God can find one more man to trust on the earth. Hope the Lord can find a delightful lady from the principles that you have learned. You will know the truth, and the truth will surely set you free. See you next time on the same station. Call any of the numbers if you have inquiries scrolling on the screen, or contact us on any of our social media platforms. God bless you. See you next week.